there, this is Yanis from Arcweave, and this is the basic tutorial series, season 2, I guess. In this episode, we will start with some crucial features concerning importing and exporting. Before anything else, let's first break the news to our pro and team users. You can now back up your Arcweave projects, exporting them as files and re-importing them back to Arcweave at will. To see how this works, let's import a little project I have prepared for the sake of this tutorial. It's a short scene that I've saved as an Arcweave file, and you can find the link to download it in this video's description. Once you download the file, go to Arcweave's My Projects, which is your projects list, and if you have a pro or a team account, you will see the option to import projects at the bottom left of your screen. So find, click on that, find your file, which is in a tavern, and open. And here it is, it's getting imported. There, and now you have your own copy of this project. Of course, I already had it here, so this is called Restored in a Tavern. You can rename it as you wish. And this is how simple it is to import a project into Arcweave. Now, let's see the reverse process. You have been working on your project, and now you want to save a backup on your drive. So this is also very easy to do. Just go to Share and Export and go to Export and then choose Backup. Again, a quick note, this is available to Pro and Team accounts only. So your only option here is to export projects, to export your project to an Arcweave file. So do that. And your project gets saved among your downloads. So once we are here, let's have a look at a couple of other new features regarding sharing and exporting, which are available to all users, including owners of free accounts. So first of all, a simple but convenient feature is the ability to export your data as a JSON file, but without having to also download all the assets of your project every time. So if you go again to Share and Export, Export, and click on JSON, you can see here a new field, this tick box here that you can tick or untick that says include assets. So if you are using JSON a lot, you will appreciate not having to go through downloading all the images every time you want to save a new JSON. One last feature for this video, which has to do with sharing a project. So far, Arcweave could either keep a project private or public. In order to let someone play your game on the play mode, you either had to invite them as viewers or you had to make your project open to the public, boards included. This is not necessary anymore. You still have the previous options. So if you go to Share and Export, let's go to Share. And here says public access, no access by default. So you still have the option to make your design and play mode public, or you can have everything private. But now there is a new option that you can make only your play mode public, and you can copy the play mode link while the rest of the project, the boards, remain private, which is really useful if you want to let the public play your game without revealing what's under the hood. So that was all for this episode concerning Arcweave's most recent features on sharing and exporting. If you find these tutorials helpful, please consider subscribing to Arcweave's official YouTube channel. You can find us, the Arcweave team, hanging out on our Discord server, and of course you can follow Arcweave on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. I'm Yanis from Arcweave. Thank you for watching, and let the games begin.